Hola, welcome to Thorlabs. My name is Daniel, and today I'm going to demonstrate on how to measure where a mounted lens focuses the light, as well as how I implement this to build a beam expander using lens tools. For today's demonstration, I'll be using two mounted lenses, a diffuser, some calipers, lens tubes, a shear-plate interferometer, a class 2 laser diode, a beam screen, and a ruler. Here, I have a lens inside a lens tube. I do not know exactly the position of the lens inside the lens tube, however, often I need to know where the position of the focus is in order to place it properly in a system. A general approach to this is to shine collimated light into the lens and try to find the focus by using a viewing screen or a business card. So, let's test it out. Now, I can see the beam in my viewing screen. I'll slide it in to try to find the exact location of the focus. As you were able to see, to find the exact location of the focus is quite difficult. Another approach is to use a diffuser. One side of the diffuser is ground rough, and the other side is polished smooth. If I place the diffuser in the beam path, we will see a speckle pattern be created on the screen. The speckle pattern is the result of the coherent light scattering from the diffuser. The bright spots are the result of constructed interference, while the dark areas are from the destructive interference. The larger the beam, the smaller the speckle. As the beam size decreases, there are less scatterers within the beam, resulting in fewer scatter waves and larger speckles on the screen. As the beam size increases, the number of scatterers in the beam increases, and there are more scatter waves to create smaller speckles. For this, I glued a retainer ring to the polished surface of the diffuser, so this lets me align the ground surface of the diffuser to the front face of the holder. I will also make sure that the ground surface is facing into the direction of the incoming light. If I move the diffuser farther away from the lens, the speckle change. Not only do we see the speckle pattern change, but we can see that the speckle size also changes as the diffuser passes through the focus of the lens. Once we see the largest speckle size, we can be confident that the ground surface is at the location of the focus. I'll now grab my calipers to measure where the focal position is. For this measurement, I'll be utilizing this section of the housing, not the threads, to the front face of my mount as my reference planes. Again, for this measurement, I'll be utilizing the same two reference planes. Now that I measure both the focal position of both lenses, I can make a beam expander. A beam expander uses two lenses, the first to focus it and the second to recollimate the beam. The ratio of the second focal length to the first will dictate on how much the beam will enlarge or contract depending if the second one is shorter than the first. And in order to assemble the beam expander, we need to position both lenses' focal position in the same spot. Now, I have a 75mm focal length lens and a 150mm focal length lens, which will make a 2x beam expander. Now that I measure both positions, I will now start measuring my lens to have the correct length. I'll start by the longer one. I will omit measuring the threads for this. Next, go for the shorter one. Lastly, for the adjustable. As well, I'm gonna make sure to add the retaining ring to my measurement. I will now proceed to assemble my lens tubes. I'll start with the large one, the shorter version. I will add this next. Well, in this situation, I should have grabbed a shorter variable lens tube. Almost done. Now that I've finished assembling my lens tubes together, I know that this is close but a little bit short to the total distance that I need between my lenses. For this, I'll be utilizing the adjustable lens tube to compensate for this. Now that I got my distance, I'll use the locking ring to secure it in place. This should be very close to the exact length that I need between my lenses. Now, for the next step to build my beam expander, I'll be adding my lenses here. For this, I have two plano-convex lenses, as now I'll be making sure that the curved surface or the convex side of each lens will be facing in the direction of the collimated light for better beam quality. I'll be starting by adding the 75mm here. And I'll be removing the 150mm lens from here to add it into my beam expander. I finished building my beam expander. I will now check if there is any final adjustments that are needed by checking its expansion and collimation. I'll be now removing the diffuser and the viewing screen as I no longer need them. Now, I'm going to start by measuring the beam before the added expansion, which is 3mm in diameter approximately. And now I'm going to introduce my beam expander into the system. We can see that we're able to obtain a 6mm spot now, which it means that we get a successful 2x expansion. However, now we're going to check for the collimation. For this, we're going to use the shear-plate interferometer. The shear-plate interferometer utilizes a wedge flat window that creates two Fresnel reflections, one at the front surface and one at the back, that will create interference that will be viewed at the top window. If we know that this is collimated, is by checking if the fringes align to the marked graving. Since the fringes are not parallel to the engraving, the collimation is a little bit off. I'll start by loosening the locking ring so that I can start making a slight adjustment. Now we can see that the fringes are parallel to the engraving. However, this also seems to be a little bit arranged. Now we can clearly see that we are off that range, so I'll be moving back a little bit where it seems to be on the midpoint of this range, which seems to be here. I'll now start by locking the position with my locking ring and secure it with my wrench. I hope you can use this in your lab someday, and if you have any further questions, please feel free to reach our tech support team. Thank you for watching.